DragGAN is an amazing AI feature that allows you to take any image and select two or more points on it. The image will then be automatically manipulated to fit those points, giving you incredible control over the transformation. I'm thrilled to announce that DragGAN has finally been released, and you can start using it right away. In this video, I'll guide you through the process of running DragGAN on Google Colab. So let's dive in. Initially, I faced some issues with the official Google Colab, but don't worry, I've added some code to make it work smoothly. Now all you have to do is simply click the Colab link provided in the video description. So, the first step is to scroll down to the video description and find the Colab link. Open it, and you'll be directed to the Colab interface. To get started, you'll need to navigate to the Runtime tab and select Change Runtime Type. Make sure you choose the GPU option from the drop-down menu. Once you've made the selection, don't forget to click Save to apply the changes. Afterward, you'll need to click on Connect to establish a connection. Once the connection is established, you'll need to go back to the Runtime tab and click on Run All. This will execute all the necessary code and ensure that everything runs smoothly. Please be patient while all the code is being executed. Once it's done, you'll be provided with two links. Click on the public link to proceed. So now that it's running on Google Colab, you'll notice the pre-trained models available in the top left corner. Feel free to try out different ones like horses, elephants, lions, dogs, humans, cats, and cars. Let's test it out with a lion. I'll select the source point and target point. Then click Start. Look at that, how cool is that? You can see the step number as it progresses. If we switch back to the terminal, we can observe each step running. It's definitely working, and the head movement looks fantastic. To download the modified image, simply click this button here. I wanted to stop it and try another one, but it was taking too long. So I decided to refresh the page and start anew. If you want to remove the points and start fresh, just click Reset Points. You can also experiment with different images by changing the seed value. And a new image is generated. Let's try the cat now. I'll adjust the cat's eye to be a little closer. Starting it. And there it is, working like a charm. It's so cool. Alright, let's hit stop and try one more. Here's the human model called FHQ. Let's give the person a bigger smile. Look at that, it's working. A bigger smile just as we wanted. It seems to work really well. So now you know how to run it, how to make it work, and how to play around with it. As soon as it becomes more stable, I'll probably create another tutorial video on how to use it. But for now, enjoy experimenting with it. Let me know what you think. If you like this video, please consider giving it a like and subscribing. I'll see you in the next one.